Welcome to this video talking about the Trace32 integration to Eclipse. Since February 2016, it is possible to use the Eclipse IDE as a user interface together with the Trace32 debugger. The communication is done over the Target Communication Framework TCF. The Trace32 PowerView user interface can be started as a so-called TCF agent. Eclipse can then connect to Trace32 PowerView over TCP/IP. It is then possible to access the Trace32 debug functionality from the Eclipse GUI. For this video, we will be using a Trace32 PowerView for R and an Eclipse IDE Mars 2. So let's start. First, we need to install the TCFC++ debugger in Eclipse. To do so, click on Help, Install New Software, then choose the update site. And type TCF in the filter. Select TCFC++ debugger and continue. Lauterbach additionally offers a plugin with a simplified and adapted launch configuration. Using this plugin, it is possible to configure and start Trace32 from Eclipse. You can install this plugin by clicking on Help, Install New Software, and the link is www.lauterbach.com/eclipse/tcf, and then continue with the install process normally. After restarting Eclipse, you should see the Trace32 TCF configuration in the debug configurations window. We will create here a new Trace32 TCF launch configuration. We can rename the new configuration and we will then use the Trace32 tab to configure and start the simulator. We are using here a simulator for ARM and we should enter the needed information. Then we will enable the TCF auto discovery. This means that Trace32 will be automatically detected by Eclipse. The port number will be also dynamically assigned. If you want to use a fixed port number, then you need to disable this option. Using the option Run Trace32 PowerView in the background, Trace32 will be started without a user interface, and debugging will be only possible through Eclipse. Finally, we will select a startup script that will be executed when Trace32 is started. This script will establish a connection to our target and loads the debug symbols. Clicking on Apply will save the configuration, and we will start Trace32 using this button. In the Target tab, we should see now the Trace32 interface under Available Targets. A double click here will display the properties of the Trace32 instance, for example the Trace32 hardware, the version and the user target architecture. In case you have disabled the TCF discovery, you can use then the new button to manually create a new target setup with the port number you have selected. We will select our instance and then click on Debug. We can view the free RTOS tasks in Eclipse Debug View with corresponding stack frame. When we select a task or frame level, the different views like source or local variables will show the respective data. The Trace32 interface can be terminated using the Terminate button in Eclipse. This is especially useful in case where Trace32 PowerView has been started in the background. Here we come to the end of our tutorial. Please refer to the following links for more information about the integration to Eclipse. Thank you for watching.